Oh my God. Hey guys, welcome back to the 3-hour new show. This is our signature segment, See the Stories. Now we just watched a great, of course, great performance from the two aerogymnasts. They are Biara Ezra Ayu Dalope and Farah Valerie Murfianda. Welcome guys. And of course,
welcome, we're going to have
a lot of chit-chat with them and the coaches here too.
Yes, right? Aside from them, we also have aerogymnastic coach Jasperin Ramona Nanleta or Coach Mona in the studio with us. So thank you so much Coach Mona, Biara, and also Farah for coming.
Thanks for coming guys.
Yeah, so congratulations first on your achievement in the 2024 Indonesian Open Aerobic Gymnastic Championship. So can you tell us more about it, more about the championship itself? Farah.
So I just want to say that for Indonesian Open, it was really amazing. We have beautiful costumes, we met a lot of amazing and talented people. And I think we speak for the both of us that the competitions that we have experienced.
Oh, she's still out of breath. Take your time. It's okay.
Maybe Biara can start.
Maybe Biara can start.
Or Kak Mona. Yeah. Oh, yeah. By the way, she doesn't want to be called Coach Mona, guys. This is Kak Mona. Maybe Kak Mona, you can
elaborate
a little bit.
Miss Mona akan translate.
Oh, okay. Yes.
Di Indonesia Open ini sangat bangga bisa mengikuti Indonesia Open ini bersama teman saya dan semua klub, semua teman-teman saya di klub ini. Saya mengikuti Indonesia Open ini sebanyak 2 kali. Jadi yang pertama itu di tahun 2023 dan sekarang 2024.
Oke.
Indonesia Open is so amazing. I'm so interesting in the competition.
Wow, yeah, she said she feels so honored to be competing
proud,
in the championship. And this is her second time. Along with Biara, your second time as well. Oh, wow.
Okay. So, Coach Mona, so these are the only two, two out of, how many in your team, in the team that's actually competing?
Actually, we have around nine athletes on this year of Indonesia Open.
This year, okay.
But actually, we have around almost 20 athletes training with our clubs, and then they are interested with aerobic gymnastics.
Okay.
But for the first of all, can I say thank you so much because you guys want to introduce us to the public, because our discipline in the sports gymnastics is not really common like or famous like artistic gymnastics or rhythmic, but thank you so much. So meaning you are really help us to spread out these disciplines around Indonesia.
Yeah, you're welcome. Yeah. And
because
again,
this is actually the first time I heard about aerobic
gymnastics.
Aerobic itself or gymnastic itself, it's pretty common we
hear, common for us.
But gymnastics. Aerobic gymnastics, we learn about it the first time now.
So now we just mentioned aerogymnastic. Maybe Kak Mona, can you explain to us the difference? Because we know, again, we hear about gymnastics just in general a lot. Yeah. But this is aerogymnastics.
Yes.
What's the difference?
So the difference, so if you want to say the definition of aerobic gymnastics, that is a competitive disciplines in gymnastics.
Okay.
Whose performance with the variety of aerobic movement pattern. If you see this, these girls perform with that is we call this aerobic movement pattern.
Okay.
Continuously with the music. Because throughout the choreography, or we call the routine, we must with the music. And then based on the traditional aerobic exercises.
Okay.
And all the routine, it must perform with the perfect execution in all components. So why it's look different? So why we are different with others? Discipline. We call us discipline in gymnastics.
Yeah, that's why it looks so energetic. Like combining all the aerobic music and the gymnastic movements. Wow. So how long did you guys prepare for the championship prior following the victory last year?
Maybe you can ask to the athletes because we as a coaches, we need to prepare them, right? But I can ask them. Berapa lama?
Farah, you wanna take this one?
We prepared for Indonesia Open for about 3 months. Regularly, we practice about 2 times a week. But when we're getting closer to our competition, it's every day except for Sunday.
Oh, so 6 out of 7 days that you guys actually practicing.
But at home, you must be practicing as well.
Yes, but if it's close, not that much at home.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Biara?
Neither do I.
Okay. All right. So getting closer, so again, still for you two, this question is for you two. Getting closer to competition, was the practice harder or tapered off to get a little bit more relaxed? But, you know, what is it? If the, I'm sure there's a difference.
Yeah.
But for preparing the routine, when we're trying to make the routine, it's a little bit harder because we're trying to memorize all the things.
Oh, yeah.
But if it's closer, it's a little bit easy, but still a little bit not stressful, just
nerve-wracking.
Yeah.
And for you, Biara, how long, how many hours do you practice a day? We want to know that too.
Jika mendekati competition, I'm practice every day.
Okay, berapa like jam? How many hours in a day?
3 hours.
3 hours, non-stop?
Yes. But jika mendekati competition-nya, dari pagi sampai sore.
Wow. Yeah.
If I want to edit, so if closer with the competition, they will practice morning and afternoon.
Okay, so, so two sessions.
Yeah, around 1 or 2 months before, they will stay in the training hall.
Okay.
So morning they practice, they rest in the training hall, eat, sleep, and everything. And after that, they continue in the afternoon. So if we combine morning and afternoon, around 3 to 4 hours.
That's pretty intense.
Very intense. So two sessions a day, getting close. So about.
But during their holiday, because all of them is a student, so
I was about to ask that. Because
it's
still
not suitable
school.
For the school days.
Right.
So what are your favorite aerogymnastic movements, and why do you like them, Farah? Because we see a lot of movements.
Yeah, there's like, I don't know, maybe capoeira was there too.
Probably it's a runoff because it looks cool.
Yeah, which one? Which one? Can you show us? Which one?
There runoff, one of the acrobatic.
Your favorite. Okay. Yeah.
So what do we call this again?
Runoff.
Round off.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. Oh, that one. Yeah.
Cartwheel landing with two legs.
Right.
Cartwheel
Cartwheel is only with one.
Legs,
right? So this is two.
Yes, two directly.
Okay.
Yeah. What about you?
My favorite movement is jumping transition.
Yeah, can you show us?
Here we go.
Oh, yeah. She landed perfectly as well. Wow.
Man, if we, Maria, I think if we tried that, you're going to have to call 911 or maybe call emergency services.
Especially me right now.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm pregnant. I don't want to try.
So, Coach Mona, we want to ask you, what are the key components when you're preparing for a routine?
So aerobic gymnastics actually have a component is aerobic movement pattern. That is the basic of so while we are different with other disciplines, and the others is transition linking, like Farah acrobatic, we call that is transition also. And then also what is the Biara.
Right.
Biara did it. And then also we have a difficulty elements. Like they did it, stress or push up. That is the basic one.
Yeah.
And then also acrobatic and difficulty we call elements. And then the last one is collaboration and partnership. Collaboration partnership. If in the number of the mixed pair 2, trio 3, and then group 5.
Group is
so
5.
We have a collaboration like lifted or something, and then partnership.
Okay.
It looks very complicated.
Yeah.
Yes. And you have to try. So you will think the differences.
I don't think so.
Yeah, because we are not even beginners. No, we don't know a thing about aerobic gymnastics. I mean, what are the components that are being judged in the championship?
Oh, yeah.
Like maybe aside from the movement, like confidence, costume. Okay.
We have difficulty elements. Mm-hmm.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. Like execution, the perfect execution. They must perform with a perfecto. Mm-hmm. And then also artistry. Artistry means all the sports, meaning related with aerobic gymnastics, it must perform with art.
Okay,
so it's not only jump, but they must art and they must have a meaning.
Okay.
So their performance, their choreography must have a meaning. Mm-hmm. Example, they choose Donet, Biara, so the choreography, the routine, it must be related with the music.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So all it must be in one component, including the
costume.
The costume. We call it leotard.
So it's beautiful.
Really, I mean, that actually makes it more complicated than I really initially thought. So you really have to think about the music, right? You really have to think about the movement
the
and make sure the movement represents something that is actually related to the music too.
Yeah.
And the artistry.
Oh, you conveyed
the art. And the costume.
Yes.
Good Lord, this is not easy.
Yeah, not easy at all.
So Kamona, how old are you guys? Farah.
I'm good.
Huh?
How old?
I am 12 years old 12. This year.
Okay, and Biara?
I am 11 years old.
Okay, oh, so just one year. So, how young can they actually start doing this?
Better is 6 years old.
Wow, it's very early.
Why? Mm-hmm. Because they already understand and can memorize something.
Okay.
If earlier than 6 years old,
right.
They still have a lot of playing or something. Mm-hmm. But 6 years, they already more have to concentrate.
I see. And last question before the break. Do you believe that some people have more talent in the movement area? I mean, in the ability to perform gymnastics, while others don't, or it can be? It can be attained with practicing.
Either you are not have a talent or gift with the flexibility or something.
Yeah, yeah. Right.
But if you train hard, if you want to motivate yourself, if you want to work hard, so you can do well.
Everyone can do it with the right practicing. Wow.
Yes, they start from, we call aerobic gymnastics, like almost zero. Now they can become like a champion in Indonesia.
So they are now, we can call them national champions.
Yes.
National
Congratulations.
Champions. Congratulations. Wow, congrats.
Wow,
for the champions.
Yes, yes,
because
for their age.
Because they have a different categorized of age.
So 12 and under for Farah age group? 12
yeah, and
under?
Age group. And national, 12 years,
12.
Yeah. Age group.
And for Farah is 11.
National development.
National
development.
Oh,
national
development.
11 years old.
Okay. Okay. So next year then Farah is going to compete in?
Age group still.
Still.
And then Bia going to age group also.
Age group, okay.
So they both of them will compete.
Wow.
In the same category.
Same category.
And then same.
Oh, okay.
From friends to competitors.
To foe, friends to
foe. No.
Well, guys, we're having a lot of fun talking about aero gymnastics here with Kak Mona, Coach Mona, and the girls, Farah and Bia. So we're going to take, but before we're going to continue, we're going to take a quick break. And I think you guys want to stay around because next segment, you're going to see me and Maria do some basic movements in aero gymnastics. Stay tuned. Let's see how we do this time.
Yeah.
Right? Do you think you guys think we're going to do okay? In this next segment.